For concerts, we're going to have the flow be you enter here and exit here. This is a small concert, so if you do want to exit through there, that should be fine for this evening. Remember to silence your cell phones. I almost said pagers and dated myself. And so I'm going to open us up with a word of prayer tonight. Heavenly Father, we come before you on this fall evening, and we just praise your name. We just praise how good you are. We praise you for your faithfulness. We praise you for just how much you love us. God, we are so grateful to be at Denver Christian School. We are so grateful for Amy Del Nero, her heart, her work ethic, her love of the children, her passion for music. She's just an incredible person, and we're just so grateful that she gets to empower our students to shine your glory and how they play and how they interact with one another. She's just such a gift. And Lord, we pray a blessing over tonight. We pray for our tech as they do some fun things for the first time for a concert. We pray for the students that they can just play with all of their heart to bring glory to you and to just have fun, because music is fun and it's joyful. And we just pray for the audience that they feel your presence tonight. They see that we are different, that we have a greater purpose as to why we're here. And we just thank you so much for being with us here tonight. In Jesus' name, amen.
Welcome. Thank you for joining us this evening. We have a great program for you tonight with several different styles of jazz spanning about 80 years. So our first song that we're going to start with, this is Sing, Sing, Sing. And I'm going to give you a little bit of background on each of the tunes because it is interesting, and it's just the history of jazz and the history of the different styles. So in early 1936, Louis Prima recorded the first version of Sing, Sing, Sing with the New Orleans Gang. This was the height of the swing era, where the music was particularly popular with young people. Prima wrote both the music and the lyrics for the song, but it didn't really gain any popularity until Benny Goodman bought it, reluctantly. In July of 1937, Benny Goodman and his band recorded their instrumental version of the song. There were a few groups that were considered the swing bands, and Benny Goodman's was one of them. The length of standard songs released at that time was about 3 to 4 minutes, so they could be recorded on one side of a 10-inch 78 RPM record. Goodman's version of Sing, Sing, Sing clocked in at 8 minutes and 43 seconds, and it took up both sides of a 12-inch 78. It still retained some of Prima's catchy riffs, but overall, the Goodman version only slightly resembled the original recording. The song became a full-out jam session featuring Benny and his band members. Recalling a recording session, band vocalist Helen Ward stated that changes in the song just started happening spontaneously. She said, "One night, Gene Krupa, the drummer, just refused to stop drumming when he got to the end of the third chorus, where the tune was supposed to end. So Benny blithely picked up the clarinet and noodled along with him. Then someone else stood up and took it, and it went on from there." This is Sing, 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 and it will feature Joe Sherwin on drums.
Thank you.
Jailhouse Rock was written in 1957 for a movie of the same name that starred Elvis Presley. It was about a young Vince Everett becoming a teenage rock star after serving time for manslaughter. Critics at the time said that this brand of rock and roll was a fad and would fade away rapidly. But Elvis Presley became a sensation, and Jailhouse Rock quickly reached the top of the charts in the U.S. It has come to be one of Elvis's most well-known songs. Rolling Stone has ranked it number 67 out of their 500 greatest songs of all time. This is Jailhouse Rock with solos by Xander Weinberger on tenor sax and Logan Kouros on trumpet. What a Wonderful World was written in 1967, a time when America had been going through the Civil Rights Movement and the Vietnam War. It was a fractured nation. The song's producer realized that the nation needed a healing message that only Louis Armstrong could provide. When Louis Armstrong was asked to sing it, he realized that the lyrics reminded him of the good aspects of his childhood growing up in a very poor neighborhood in New Orleans. You might recognize the lyrics. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They'll learn much more than I'll ever know. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Armstrong was arrested at the age of 11 and sent to a home for juvenile delinquents, where he learned how to play the cornet. He went on to become one of the greatest jazz trumpeters of all time and developed scat singing, a form of vocal improvisation. This is What a Wonderful World. The title of our next song, Libertango, merges the two words liberty and tango, symbolizing the break from classical tango to tango nuevo, an evolution of tango dance that took off in the 80s. Libertango was written by the Italian composer Astore Piazzolla and premiered in Milan in 1974. The main instrument featured in the original is the concertina accordion, which is an accordion that consists of expanding and contracting bellows with buttons on both ends. Libertango is one of the most popular tangos ever written. Although it never gained huge popularity in the US, the composition has appeared on more than 500 separate releases. Libertango will feature Asher Haas on alto sax. Although I'm sure you all know our next tune, you may not know how it came about. Don't Stop Believin'. Prior to joining Journey as the keyboardist, Jonathan Cain was part of a band called The Babies. The band was sidelined when the lead singer injured his leg. Unemployed and not knowing where to turn, Cain called his father, asking him if he should come home to Chicago and give up on his musical dreams. His father, a devout Christian, told him, no, don't stop believing. Later, as Cain was settling into his new role in Journey, Steve Perry, the lead singer, asked him if he had any songs that he could write. Cain went to his lyrical notebook and on the last page found what his father had said to him that night on the phone, don't stop believing. He built the piano line and the bass and the bassist, and it went from there. Cain was very close to his father, and when he passed, he felt completely lost. Sitting at the piano in tears, he remembers thinking that he always wrote music for his father. God spoke to him in that moment and said, no, you were writing for me. You were always writing for me. Cain looked back on his songs, Open Arms, Faithfully, and realized they were all about God. He has since become a Christian artist and leads worship at a church in Florida where his wife is the lead pastor. Don't Stop Believin' will feature Asher Haas on alto sax and Adrian Scruse on piano.
Thank you.
Well, before we start our last tune, I just want to thank everybody again for coming tonight. I'd like to thank my team, Jen Last, Brandon King, who's up there, Brandon Witters, Kurt Stroman, Elena Nacarado, everybody that's just been a huge support for me right now. I lost my dad on Saturday, and today was my first day back, and I didn't know if I could do it, but this is why I'm here, and it was I love each and every one of you dearly, and like Mrs. Last said, music is truly an amazing thing. And I'm not sure, you know, aside from prayer, I don't know if there's a greater connection to God than music. So the fact that we get to do this, like, every day, don't take it for granted, okay? None of us, we can't take it for granted, because this is an amazing thing that we're able to do. So super proud of these guys. We have a lot of new members this year, and they're just working really hard, and they're doing an amazing job. So just thank you to everybody for all of your love and your support. I couldn't be at a better place right now. So just love Denver Christian. Thank you, guys. Our last tune, Bruno Mars's Uptown Funk, was released in 2014 and reached the top of the charts in 19 countries, making it the most successful Ronson and Mars single to date. The song has a sound similar to 1980s era funk, but also includes elements of soul, boogie, disco, pop, and R&B. The song started through a jam session with Mark Ronson on bass, Bruno Mars on drums, and another band member on keyboard. They got the groove going, put it on a loop, and then came up with the melody and added lyrics to it. Through the lyrics, Bruno Mars channels his inner James Brown as he sings about his style, his swagger, and his love for his city. The song celebrates individuality and confidence. This is Uptown Funk. Yeah.
where this came from.